Cross is a Catholic school in the LaSallian tradition. However, St. John Baptist de La Salle is not our only founder of Carver that we look up to for inspiration. We also have Monsignor Bartholomew Frawley, Bishop Daniel Delaney, St. Mary of the Cross MacKillop, and our patron saint, Mary Help of Christians. We are a multi-charism school here at Southern Cross. So what does this mean? Well, to answer this question, I found some experts in these fields to talk about their founders and our patron saint, Mary Help of Christians. Welcome to Getting to Know Your Founder.
And I'm Charlotte Gould.
We're 2020 Delaney House Captain.
So this year our patron's day will look a little different, and this video is getting to know our founder.
So Delaney, our patron saint, is Daniel Delaney. He was born in Ireland in 1747, and from a very young age he wanted to become a priest. However, at the time it was illegal for young men to study the priesthood, and he was in turn smuggled to France, where he studied for 14 years and became a priest. He also began lecturing at universities there.
Yep, so desiring to see his mother here return from Ireland, he was appalled at the state of his country and the condition of his church. So at the age of 30, Daniel tried sermons and house-to-house visits, but these did not come with much success. So he turned his attention to the youth.
So he began Sunday school, and these grew so quickly, in fact, that he had to train other members of the community, because all people of ages were attending these schools. And his legacy began in 1807. Daniel Delaney gathered six women from Tullow and started the Brigidine Sisters.
So Bishop Delaney chose St. Bridget as the patroness of the congregation, thereby linking it to the spiritual heritage of St. Bridget, patroness of Ireland. We draw our inspiration from the way Daniel Delaney lived his life, his personal motto, act with strength and gentleness.
This is something that we embed into our lives here at Southern Cross.
Hi, it's Livin Bailey here, and we're your Frawley House Captains, and we'll be talking about our patron, Bartholomew Frawley. So Monsignor Bartholomew Frawley was born in Toowoomba in 1904. Throughout his life, he was described as a humble, loving, giving and compassionate man who always had an air of dignity and tranquility to everyone he met. He was always community-minded, knew every child's name and was always saying, it's 95% God's work and 5% your own.
He firstly became a secondary teacher after graduating school and then later served as a parish priest through the 1930s. He sacrificed his life to serve in the Royal Australian Air Force during World War II. Frawley accomplished so much in his lifetime. However, what we recognise as the most significant contribution to our community was the Frawley College he built, which is what we are sitting in today. It was originally just one level until a storm blew the roof off the building, so the Mons suggested to add another two stories.
The Southern Cross community has a lot to learn from Monsignor Frawley. Not only his qualities of determination and innovation, but his persistence through all the struggles he had to face in his life. As he said, you come into this world with nothing and leave with nothing. But what do you want to leave behind?
Hey guys, I'm Ella.
And I'm Dante.
We just wanted to make a short video about the founder of our house for our annual Patron's Day.
Now, as most of you guys know, we're the La Salle Captains, meaning that our house patron is St. John Baptist de La Salle.
St. John was born into a wealthy family on the 30th of April in 1651 in France, and throughout his life he became a tutor, a priest and a teacher.
He soon became the patron saint for educators, as he wrote books and held retreats for teachers, in which he taught them to have a sense of vocation and to have a mission.
He not only taught these educators how to teach and care for young people through free education, he also encouraged everyone to help the poor when possible.
St. John was also known to provide innovative teaching methods and hence encouraged educators to think differently about their role, ultimately creating a better learning environment.
Us as students at Southern Cross are encouraged to live out his legacy and take up the LaSallian mission as our school models itself on the teachings of St. John.
We can do this by acting as brothers and sisters to all and by living out the five core principles of the LaSallian school, which includes respect for all persons,
faith in the presence of God,
inclusive community,
quality education,
and concern for the poor and social justice.
St. John Baptist de La Salle is the perfect role model for both students and teachers as he showed all of these values throughout his life. So we should all strive to follow in his footsteps.
Hey guys, we're the MacKillop House Captains. I'm Jade.
And I'm Jasmine.
And today we're going to be talking about our founder, Mary MacKillop. Mary MacKillop dedicated her young life to a life of service to God, as she was a woman of faith, courage and determination, who showed what a generous, ordinary person can become with a purpose, just like the Southern Cross mission that seeks to serve the wider community, promote dignity and justice for all people. Mary dedicated her life to the promotion of education, especially in small towns that might not otherwise have that chance.
She had very high ethics and morals and was always willing to do the hard work that no one else wanted to do, to help the homeless, the poor, the orphan and the uneducated. She sowed seeds of compassion in the world and fought for justice. in a time when it was hard for a woman to have a voice, especially in the Catholic Church. Her plight was not without its battles.
Southern Cross Catholic College's mission is to seek the light and then we shine. And I think Mary MacKillop helped bring people out of their darkness into the light.
Mary Help of Christians is Southern Cross Catholic College's patron saint. Mary was a courageous and caring woman who devoted her life to God and carried her son Jesus Christ in her womb. She left a lasting impression on the lives of those she touched personally through her actions, but even more so, those who she touched through her legacy that she left behind.
The infant church in colonial Australia had a special reason for turning to Mary. No priest was sent to the colony in the early days, and mass was not allowed except for one brief year until 1820. It was largely the rosary that kept the faith alive, and many turned to Mary for inspiration and guidance. The Australian Catholic community has always held Mary in a high regard because of this, and Australia was the first nation to choose her under the title Mary Help of Christians as principal patroness.
The constellation of the Southern Cross has always been associated with Australia, and so when the name Southern Cross Catholic College was decided upon to be the name of the amalgamated college in 1995, the country's principal patroness was chosen as college patron. Mary's feast day is the 24th of May, and it highlights not only the strength we find in asking for Mary's intercession, but the confidence that God continues to act in the world.
So there you have it. I hope this video has taught you a little bit more about Southern Cross's founders and our patron saint, Mary Help of Christians. Mary Help of Christians,
pray for us.
Live Jesus in our hearts
forever.